These are the new Fagelli Super Duty actuators, and they're called Super Duty because they truly are Super Duty. They're very quite robust and heavy duty. They kind of standard is 220 pounds and 450 pound force, which is quite a bit in such a small compact size like this. So they do pack quite a bit of a punch. They come as 12 volts or 20 volts as standard, and come with feedback control, hall sensor feedback control. If you want to use it, you don't have to use it. If you don't want to, just ignore those wires at the end of the harness if you don't want to use them. They're stainless steel construction, very rugged. And best thing is they're IP66 rated, so they're practically waterproof, which is great. They're suitable for outdoor applications, and they're very sturdy, very tough. And they're also pretty quiet too. Plug one into our new Fagelli touchscreen controller here, and we'll just run it here to demonstrate the noise. There you go. If you can hear that, but it's pretty quiet. This is the 450-pound force and 12-volt model. 24-volt will run a bit faster. The wiring diagram is on the label. It tells you exactly how to wire it up. And here I'm hooking it up to the Fagelli controller, where you can adjust the speed, the limit switches, and also have timer control. And you can even run them in sync. So I can quite easily plug in a second one here to the controller. Tell the controller running two, then do a quick calibration. So the first thing you have to do when you want to run a couple of actuators in sync using the Fagelli control board, which can sync up to four actuators, first thing you want to do is calibrate them. And that's so that the computer can count the amount of revolutions the whole sensor signal gives off. And so what it does for that, it runs through an entire cycle all the way to the end, all the way to the bottom, and then syncs those pulses so that when you do run it manually, they'll be completely in sync. Okay, so first thing you did there, retracted them. Now it's running them both together. You can see it's running them together. It's syncing them. It's gonna do a full stroke all the way to the end, all the way back, where it's counting the signals. And these, because these are heavier, higher force actuators, they do come with the larger clevisoles on both ends. And we have our own specific bracket that you can use with these, or you can build your own bracket. And there we go, it's just got to the end. Now it's retracting. And as I said, you can sync up to four of these using this control box, which is great if you're lifting something that needs to come up at the same time, where you could potentially have some extra load on one corner. Say if you're lifting a table or something like that, where you've got extra weight on one side, you want the others that are not pushing as much weight to compensate for it. And then just about retracted. So you can see this one was a little bit faster than this one. So now, hit flash three times, click three times the control box, it's ready to go. So now we run them, they will run perfectly in sync. That's gonna be quite difficult to see it, but they are perfectly synced. And if I was to add pressure in one of them, although these are pushing 450 pounds, I'm probably not going to really do any damage there. But if you try to slow one down, the other one will automatically slow down to keep up with exactly the same pace. And here we go, they're running now. You should see them stop there, both at exactly the same time. First, now let's try it with three. Now I have three Super Duty actuators all hooked up to the controller. I've already done the calibration, and if we run them now and run them all together, very difficult to see if they're actually running all together, but they are running perfectly in sync. But when they're not calibrated and you run actuators without calibrating them, or without synchronizing them, they all run at different speeds. Actuators just all run at slightly different speed for many different reasons. That's why you have to do a sync use a sync box like this. See, they all stopped perfectly